We have the ingredients. Okay, so we have like the pie. We have the pie that I did not make. It's store-bought, but it's really, really delicious and buttery. Of course, we have our salt. We have self-rising flour, unbleached self-rising flour. I do like King Arthur flour. Then, of course, we have 4 apples. I don't think these are different apples. I took off the labels and washed these, but I believe that we have a Red Delicious. We have a Macintosh, we have a Gala, and we also have a Cortland. Those are the 4 different kinds of apples that I'm deciding on using. The only apple that I wouldn't use is Washington apples. They just don't make for a good pie. They just make for plain eating, okay, or dipping. Because it's kind of like a rough apple. Okay, then we have the sugar and we have butter. And really that's all that we need to make this delicious pie. Okay, let's get to it. All right, hi, this is the video that I promised you guys that I was going to make for you. And today we're going to make Dutch apple pie in the eye. I'm so lame with my jokes, okay? And sorry about the like high sheen on my face. Oh my god, I don't have any setting powder, but we're not worried about that, are we? We're here to make some delicious food, a little pie for you, for all of us that you can share with friends and you can also share with your family. Okay, so let's get it. I already showed you the ingredients of what we're going to need, so let's just get with that, with the cooking and everything. I'm really excited. Okay, so I'm just gonna peel these apples here. I love this peeler. Super awesome, fast. Anyways, you guys, like, you don't even know. How was everybody's Thanksgiving? How did it go? I saw that like a couple of you like left comments about what you guys are going to serve as side dishes. Unfortunately, I got to like, you got to me a little bit too late. But what I decided to do is just do a few like extras, nothing over the top. Like I did French green onion casserole. Am I saying that right? And then also I did like some mashed potatoes with using yellow or gold green potatoes, and those came out really great. And then what else did I make? All right, we got one down. Yes, we have, you know what, we have 3 more to go, because I'm like debating on whether to like do 2 pies or just 1. I think, but then if I do 2, I don't know if I'll have enough. Like generally you should have about 3 apples per pie, but sometimes the apples are so huge, like this one's not so huge, but sometimes the apples are so huge that I have enough for 2 pies. So like back to what else did we eat? Oh my gosh, I don't even remember. Oh, of course. We had like Bell's stuffing. Delicious. And Campbell's like gravy. And I did go ahead and I did the ham. And it turned out really, really moist and so delicious, you guys. Like, it was to die for. And I'm so glad that I went with that instead of the stupid turkey. But I did tell my kids, because they do like turkey, that for Christmas I will do the turkey, okay? Yeah. But like the one thing I'm like, now I know is that I should, the YouTube video that I watched, they said that, just to put it in there, like on a rack, blah, 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 right? The point is that I did it that way and it got too crispy too early. This one's a little, oh goodness. So next year I'm just gonna put some tin foil over it And then, like, at the end, I'll take it off, like, the last hour and a half or something, so it can get crispy. But, yeah, that, like, the sauce that I used and everything, it came out amazing. And I did, after, like, usually, I know this is really bad, you guys, but, like, I usually, like, when the part of the turkey that we don't eat, we chuck it. I know that's terrible, but, and I hate wasting like that. But this one, the ham, you know that I cut that ham up and I froze what we weren't going to use right away. And then I left some out in a tin foil that we can make sandwiches with and stuff. Yeah, like, and it's been coming in handy too. We make like pea soup and sandwiches. And then, yeah. I usually use chicken for my fettuccine, but I put the ham in the fettuccine. They didn't care. My kids did not care. So they were loving it. And then, oh, what else did I have? I also had like, what do you call those? Like hot cross buns. They were awesome. I almost actually forgot to cook them. And I'm like, oh, heck no. I'm gonna put everything aside. Let me just throw these in the oven really quick. And they came out great. It's the kind that you have to like actually put butter on top and then just bake them for a little bit. Toast them up. And that's bomb. Like, you dip it into the gravy. Ugh, oh, it's very country like. Yeah. Let me stop this up right here with my hot cross buns. Yeah, and this gravy, delicious. Okay, so now I'm gonna move these over here onto the cutting board and get these cut up, okay? Maybe I don't have to stop the video. I'll just come over here really quick. Okay, so I have my knife here. Excuse my wet knife, it got like melted. So let's do this really quick but safe. All right, so I'm also gonna take the hard part out, the shell. I don't know, it's the core, man. Okay. I was watching Stinky Wrinkle. You guys, oh my god, I was watching like Stinky Wrinkle. Who do you guys think Stinky Wrinkle is, by the way? I'm starting to suspect it's Wendy, but I'm not really sure. But I don't know, because she puts up like a lot of Wendy videos. But anyways, I miss Wendy. I hope that she comes back, and I hope that she does know that she probably is not back yet because, you know, she's like, I wanted my stuff to be monetized to make a little cash on the side, you know. But I hope that she knows that, yes, Google is great and Google AdSense, but you can also get sponsored by other companies online. They have that. I don't know if you guys know that. Yeah. All right. Ooh, it's slipping. All right. It doesn't necessarily have to be long ones. Yeah, I looked that up. I put this in the dishwasher here, and now it's all Willy Wonka. Don't fall on the floor. I need you, Apple. I need you. Every last one of you. All important slices to me. Apple slices are so important. I don't know, like, it's so funny. This morning, I was going around cleaning the house. Then I was like, I don't know, like, a few things I was saying, like, I was like, in like a southern accent. I don't know. I can be goofy like that, you guys. Mama. So, what up with other stuff? What's going on here? What's going on? Okay, you guys, like, Did you hear about Kanye West? Did you guys hear about him? Oh my God. Okay, so listen, as I told you guys in the comment section, I am not like so much into that music. I'll sit there and I'll listen to it, but it's not something where I'm like, oh my God, I gotta go to the concert. I gotta know everything. I'm like not a hardcore fan like that. You know, give me my 80s music and I'm legit set. So let's put I am gonna dump this in this big bowl, which I love. Okay, you guys might be like, well, of course I would have these things in my kitchen, but you know how I attained these? There was a time when, and I'll get to the Kanye West thing, but there was a time when I was on a cooking, like, it wasn't regular food, like meat and veggies, that kind, but I was really, really in the baking, like a baking run. Like, I just wanted to bake everything, double chocolate cake, just like the whole shebang. So I got so excited that I went out and I bought all new stuff, all of this stuff. And yeah, but it was still worth it. I still use the stuff, but like, yeah, I was just feeling the cooking, the baking thing, and I was loving it. Oh my God, I think I gained, like, I'm already, like, big girl. I'm a big girlfriend. But, yeah, I think I gained, like, mad weight, and I think that's why I stopped for a while. And then I stopped, period, wanting to, like, bake all the time. But I was, like, in the mood. My favorite things were like cake and the kids. You know what was really exciting? It's because the kids went gaga over my cooking, and that like brought me like, oh my God, they love things that I made with my own hands from scratch. Oh my God, I would make like different kinds of cookies, the whole shebang. So yeah, I got all this stuff. And so like, it's really shocking to me because I'm not really too much of a chef. I can cook. Believe me, but it's like when you're a mom, it's like this, it stops becoming like a special type of thing. It's more like, oh, this is something you have to do. I think that's why I just don't like cook every day. I don't know, but that Yvonne Chania, she cooks often too. She loves it. Anyways, back to Kanye West. Okay, I'm sure, now I know some of you, fan or not, you know, you didn't hear the 411. Okay, so Kanye West had a concert, right? He was doing a concert, and he had did about 2.5 songs. All the reports say something different, that he did 3 songs, that he did 2 songs. He did 2.5 songs, and then he did a song and a half. Whatever, it doesn't matter. I think that he actually did a song and a half, okay? And so the half of the song, that's when he interrupts his music, and he's like, hold up, wait, okay? Then he goes on this long 1 hour, guys, 1 exact hour long rant. Or speech, rather, talking about Donald Trump and how amazeballs he is, and how, you know, Hillary, you know, this country has failings. I don't know. He was just saying some crazy things, and that, you know, it's time for it. Like we need Trump. We need this. I don't know. You guys can actually go. It's on YouTube. You guys can go and like listen to his long ass speech if you want to. It's really, like, crazy. Like, people pay... Let me tell you something. People pay, like, a lot of friggin' money to go see this dude. Some people didn't pay their rent just to go see that dude, right? I'm telling you. Believe me. I know. Some of you, it's kind of easy to get, you know, but some people had to travel there. You know, they had to flip, like, travel costs, you know, gas, whatever. Okay, so like people go out of their way to pay for these friggin' expensive concert tickets. Too expensive for him to interrupt the concert with some damn lame speech. about Donald Trump politics? Like, really? It wasn't even about somebody I care about. I know he's our president now, but yeah. But okay, then he puts in the speech. He puts in the speech, you guys, like, is this, okay, it is recording. Yeah, he puts in a speech, yeah, just so you know, I didn't vote, but I do support Donald Trump. Oh, really, fool? Really? You didn't vote? Okay, so my opinion on that is that if you did not vote, you don't get a say on what happens in this country. That's just my opinion. You guys might think differently. But literally, you can't sit up there and saying, like, oh, who's the better man or woman for the job? You can't say, well, I think this country needs this and, you know, like, have this huge-ass opinion. It's kind of like, and I know, like, I'm not, like, religious, but I'm just going to throw it out here like this. It's kind of like preaching on the Bible, right? It's kind of like preaching on the Bible and you haven't read the Bible, which tons of people do. It's like the same thing to me. Like, dude, you can't educate me on anything. You have no right to an opinion on what happens to this country, who should run it, blah, 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 when you don't vote. It's so important, you guys, to vote. Like, whether you like who's running or not. I mean, because there's always a lesser evil, if you will. Like, it's really, really important. But if you're not going to participate in, like, they need you. These people need you, like, to want to run this country. And, yeah. So, anyways, let's get back to the whole thing, okay? So, yeah. So, now, an hour later, he finishes up his, speech. And then he announces, he says exactly this. Get ready for this. And guess what? He jumps off the hovering stage and he said, concert's over. What? Oh my God. Those people must have been so livid. I know I would be. Like, oh my God. Okay, so we're gonna put this in here. That is a lot of apple. That is a lot of apple. I think that is actually enough for two pies. I'm not really sure as of yet. But okay, let's get to it. So, okay, now for the, so here we have it. So what we're going to put in here now is a half a cup of sugar. Okay, so I have my sugar over here. Half a cup. So should I use this one? You know what? Let's just use the, I was going to put it in the cups, but why? This will do, a half a cup of sugar. Let's put it over the sink so it doesn't spill. When it does spill, you'll have to clean it up. So I'm gonna sprinkle that over all the apples. And okay, so the next thing we're going to do is put a teaspoon of cinnamon. So where are my, oh, here they are. Put them in there. Measuring cup. So a teaspoon. Here's one teaspoon. And I'm going to reach over, you guys. Sorry. Excuse moi. Okay, so I have my cinnamon. I'm going to take the cup. Do you guys think that I use enough cinnamon? Look at it, it's like halfway gone. Oh yeah, I love cinnamon. Okay, so a half. Make sure it's good. See, there's a half. I'm gonna sprinkle it on here. Alrighty. And as you go, you guys, like, I know, like, a lot of people, they don't like the whole cooking thing for one reason or other, like, because it's cleanup afterwards or what have you. Some people actually don't mind cooking, but they just hate, the cleaning up portion of it. So as you go, you should clean up. Like, so when you're done with one thing, like the sugar, put it away. So put that away. Put the cinnamon away. Okay, so this is all we actually need for this. Okay, oh, and then also a teaspoon of salt. I forgot the salt. So I'm gonna grab over here. So this is only gonna be like a half teaspoon of salt. So I'm gonna use these again. I usually have my, I ran out. I always have this for emergency, but I always use sea salt. It's just better for you. It doesn't have all the, the reason why is because, sorry, because they have the preservatives in here and iodine and, you know, but the sea salt doesn't. So it's a half a teaspoon of salt. Okay, that's a lot. Okay, so, okay, and then we're gonna sprinkle that in here. Putting this, the salt away, clean up as you go along. When you're done, you won't be overwhelmed. Now, what we're going to do is, I'm going to bend down here in my dishwasher because I totally forgot. I just cleaned them, but I like to rinse just excess stuff. Okay, and now, here's the fun part. I get to mix it up. And cinnamon, be careful, you guys, because the cinnamon can go all over the place. Make sure that you get all the excess on. What the heck? There was an apple I didn't cut up. You know why I didn't cut it up? Because I was so thinking about Kanye West, which I didn't even finish on, which I will in a minute. Am I doing okay, you guys? Like, is this all over the place? So yeah. And another piece that I didn't cut up. Did you guys see that? Like, oh dang, she threw that in there. She didn't even finish the apple. See, this is like Julia Child's kitchen. That woman was a French, famous French chef, okay? Oh my goodness, she would make so many mistakes. And you know what, people loved her for it. They liked her for that. They're like, yeah, girl, like, that's a real woman in the kitchen, not being all perfect and having mishaps. So consider me Julia Child's today. And I'm gonna continue mixing this up. Did I get all the apples now? Yay. Is that good? Did you guys see this? Because it's like a lot of apple. I think it's still good. And like, you think that this looks really, really dry, but do understand, like, when apples heat up, they sweat, like, a lot. So it's like a half a cup of water. I mean, it's insane. So, no, you like, oh, this is really dry. No, you're good. Okay, so now what I want to do, I'm going to take my pie crust, which is right here, and put this over here. Can I tell you, like, the first time I made this pie, I didn't know it came with two, and I baked them together. I am not joking. Okay, so what I'm going to do is actually put it right away on the pie plate, the pan, the cookie sheet. There you go. And now I'm going to evenly dump the apples in here. This is kind of fun, you guys. Oh my gosh, you know what? I might do this more often. What do you guys think? Leave a comment below if you like this. Yeah, see? It's enough for like two pies. Word. Word. Word, y'all. Word. Okay. So it's not going to like overfilling apple pie, but yeah, word. Yes. Okay, I might take a pie to my friend's work so everybody can have a pie and keep one for my fam. Oh, and then like Oh, see those pieces of apple. Okay, so I got my spatula, so I can go ahead and dump this. Can you guys see? Ba ba ba. Okay, so waste not, want not. You know what? My mom, no, not my mom. My godmother used to say that to me all the time. Waste not, want not. I friggin' never knew what she meant by that until I got like in my 30s or something. And I'm like, oh. Okay, so yes. Okay, so here we go. Now, with these, I'm gonna put this aside. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna rinse this out really quick. Okay. Get my pies wet. Alright, so I'm just like cleaning up my sink. You just want to see everything. I put it right down the garbage disposal. You know what? The one thing I don't put it down here anymore is like rice, because the maintenance men, they hate when I like throw rice on here because it clogs it up. I'm like, whatever. But now I kind of accommodate them. I don't do it. But stuff like apple. Fine, right? All right, darlings. So, yeah. We're going to come back over here. Now we're going to put these two apples. And there goes my phone. Aside. And we're going to take like a smaller bowl. Okay, so yeah, this is like the crazy part. Okay, so we're gonna take my smaller bowl. I'm thinking, should I do the bigger bowl? The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to actually make the pie topping. Now, this is a Dutch apple pie. So we're not going to do the regular, you know, the top of the pie where you roll it out with a rolling pin. So this is actually going to be a very delicious, delicious crumble topping. And believe me, you guys, like, believe me, it tastes so much better than that sheet of floured whatever it is that they put on top of this. Here is boss bomb. Oh my god. Okay. So it's, yeah, so we're gonna get to it. Okay, let's go back down. Here we go. We got it. Okay, so the next ingredient we're going to need here is this is King Arthur's flour. You don't have to use King Arthur's, but that's a brand that I love. And here we're going to use the measuring cup. So we're going to use, I'm going to put it in here in the sink. All this filling stuff, like sugar and flour and stuff, do it in the sink. So like if there's like any extras flying around, you're not getting it all over your counter and everywhere, okay? So we're going to actually use 3/4 self-rising flour, which this is. Okay, so 3/4. You know what? I'm gonna use my smaller cup. This is a, these are really good. These are Pyrex, and they are, they come in, I broke my big one before I even got to use it. It smashed. I was so upset. It was like a big mixing bowl, like size. Big, you guys. I had the whole set. This is a cup, and that's a 2-cup, and then I had the big mixing bowl. But anyways, we're going to do like 3/4. Okay, so I want to like pat it, make sure it's correct. So this is for 2 pies, so that is 1/3. 3/4, I should have did a cup and a half, but actually. So for 2 pies, it would have been a cup and a half. 3/4, okay, here we go. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is, a 1/2 cup of sugar. Like, Can you guys give me suggestions on what you think I should improve on this? I don't know if you guys like how I'm doing this whole cooking thing. Okay, so we have like a half a cup. This is half? Yes. The sugar that I put away, because I forgot that I'm going to need it today. All right, so half a cup. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. All right, so here's the sugar. I'm gonna sprinkle in with the self-rising flour. Okay, so we add some, oh, and then like another one, right? I forgot we're doing 2 cups. So you guys can like watch me pour the sugar. Oopsies. Place not, want not. Perfect. Alright, I just dumped that in there. Alright, putting my sugar away. Let's go back, darlings. Rat hair. Rat hair. Okay, so now we're going to do 3/4. So I'm going to take this knife here and cut a third. It's marked on here, so a third. It's kind of melty, so we don't want melted butter. So I'm going to like, put this one away. Oh my goodness, and get out another stick. All right, so this one's definitely more hard. Okay. So, and then another third. And then I'm gonna put this away. Don't worry, that butter is not going to waste because I love real butter. Okay, so let's put this in really quick. Ugh. Heavens! Let's put that in there. Heaven's bits, that looks so delicious, guys. Oh my goodness, my godmother would be absolutely proud of me. Yes, she would. Okay, she's not a southerner, but she is an Irish lady. Okay, so, alright, so now we're going to mix it up. This is the part I don't like. That was easy. So we're going to like mix, 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 mix. Okay, because I want to get all the everything that we put in there together. Alright. And now we're going to take our fist, man. And then we're going to boom, boom, boom. Use our fist. Oh my gosh, that heart, the frozen, that frozen butter, no way. It's not frozen, but it's definitely cold. All right, I'm gonna have to like break it up with my fingers. And then just use your fist to like really grind it in. It's going to be like a very like, how do you say, crumbly? That's what Dutch is, like just crumble topping. Okay. And yeah. All right, I'm used to cooking. Yeah, see all this? Yeah, because you don't want it fully melted. So if you're gonna do this, guys, like, and you don't want it too hard, like it just came from, just put it out for like a little bit on the counter. And now I just use my fist to like, you think this butter won't be enough, but it actually will. Scrape it from the bottom. Turn. Oh my gosh. See how it's getting crumbly? But I'm not even remotely close to getting this together. Like you wanna like okay. It has to be like crumbly. Like, you can't have any, like, loose flour floating about, because that's not doing the Dutch. So like, I have like all this loose flour. No, 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 all that has to be solidified. So while I'm doing this, so let me finish up about the Kanye West. Oh, you thought it was over, darlings? No. Okay, so here's the like really like tense part of it, you guys. Okay, so now many people are reporting different things, and the nicer reports, I really feel like it's a cover up by the family. Okay, because this is what I think. Okay, so Kanye West was like, he was dragged out of his home. He had to go to a psychiatric evaluation, and he had no choice of the matter but to go. So do you know what that means? The only time they do that is if somebody is actually suicidal. Like, they've actually said, they verbalized that, I don't want to be here anymore. Like, he actually said, like, you know, so, because the only time you really would get dragged in, you have no choice in the matter, is that, like, you're in danger to yourself or to others. Or it's court ordered, or, yeah, it's basically that. Like, you have, you know. But anyways, so, what happened? So, apparently, Kanye West called his psychiatrist. Now, why does he have a psychiatrist to begin with? Like, that's concerning. They did call him a coach, but it's like a counselor. Okay. And, all right, so this is together. I'm going to put this over here. Let's get this done, okay? So, let me finish quickly saying this. Yeah, so Kanye West, yeah, he had to be handcuffed to the gurney. He was forced out of his home. They had to drag him out of his home because they said that it was sleep deprivation, but I don't think so. I think that somebody like him, like, I think that he has ongoing issues, you know what I mean? And because of stress, that usually brings that out. And he just, like, yeah. And so he had to go in on the 21st of November, right before Thanksgiving. So sad. And his family, I don't know, like, it's all over the news, you guys. That doesn't necessarily mean that you would know about it. Okay, this could have had a little bit more apple, but I don't have any more apple. But anyway, so I'm like, if you guys can see, sorry. Shoot. I don't want to touch my tripod. My hands get dirty. Sorry, you guys. I'm shaking ya. I just want you to see. Okay. So, this, you're going to, like, not just clump it in there, but sprinkle it. And meanwhile, while you're doing it, you're going to be breaking up the... breaking up the Dutch topping. Let's make it even. So some over here. I could have definitely went for an extra apple. So yeah. But this is gonna come out so delicious. So if you're gonna ask me, like, oh, can I use margarine? No, you can't. I've tried that. I tried it. That was my third pie that I tried. I'm like, I didn't have any butter. And so it just came out a horrible, it just melted all over the place. It just turned into like a oil. And it was just, I was like, oh no, 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 no. Just put a little bit here, a little here. Yeah, this one looks like it needs mostly. Okay. Okay. Let me rinse off my hands really quick. I'm over here. All right. So, let me just remember, you guys, clean up as you go along. When you're done, you're going to be like, ugh, there's nothing to do but dishes, which my dishwasher will take care of that.
Okay. Okay, you guys. So, we finally finished that. So, what did you think about the Kanye West thing? Okay. I'm all over the place. Okay. So, okay, you guys. So, now we finished the pies, preparing it. Now we're going to put the two pies in a 450 degree oven. And only for 10 minutes. Guys, please, and you want to preheat your oven. So before you even start this whole process of cutting up the apples, what have you, you want to preheat your oven because it does take, everybody's oven is different, but it definitely does take, it's just all different. So yeah, 450 degrees, and then you want to put the pies in for 10 minutes. Do not go over 10 minutes. I don't know what it is, but if you go over 2-3 minutes, it's just gonna mess it up. Okay, so I'm gonna bring you over here to my oven. Oh, and so like after, should I cut that part out? Okay, so but after the 450 degrees in there for 10, the apple pies in there for 10 minutes, then you want to turn the oven down to 350 degrees, and then you're going to bake the apples for another additional 40 minutes. Okay, so that's very important. When that time is over, you're going to take them obviously out of the oven and put them in a cooling rack. So like, I don't live in a house where I have a cooling rack. So what I do is like I put the pans like kind of like over the sink, you know, where it doesn't fall in, but like so the heat will escape from the bottom, and you know, so it'll cool off easier. You don't want to eat these like right away. So if you're doing this for like for dinner or whatever, you want to do this early in the morning, early afternoon, whatever, because the pies really need to rest. The reason why that is because when you cut into the pies, there's going to be so much syrup from the sugar, the cinnamon, and the apples. It's going to be very syrupy, and basically it's just going to like drain out when in your slice, you know. So you definitely want this to rest for a couple of hours before you go ahead and eat them. I know it's gonna smell so delicioso, and then you can't have any for 2 hours, so make sure you've eaten. This is gonna be for dessert or for tomorrow. Okay, so yep, so we're gonna put them in the oven right now. Okay, here they are. We're gonna put them in the 450 degree oven for only 10 minutes. Put it on the top. I gotta pay attention. Haven't burnt myself yet, but. Okay, so as you just, Lord. Okay, so as you see, I put it in the oven, okay. You wanna put it in on the top, on the middle rack. So, if it's you don't have a middle rack, adjust them. Just take the racks out and put it in. So you guys, I just want to add this last bit of thing with for you guys. Listen, now a lot of people, us ladies and gentlemen, who you know, you just really don't think that I can make pies and cakes and or dinner or breakfast even or lunch. I did not say that in order. But people kind of tend to stay away from that because like they're thinking it's so difficult. You're like a magician, you know, putting all this in a cauldron, like it's just impossible, right? No, it's really not. If you really take the time to sit down and educate yourself, get some recipes and really follow through, you know, it's really, 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 really easy. Listen, I used to be that person who used to go ahead and buy like all frozen dinners or just really, really fast stuff that's really, really unhealthy for you. The majority of the food that I have in my home are like, I have tons of seasonings, and I even do like rosemary. So like some rosemary, hallelujah. That shit smells great. But you know, different like seasonings, you guys. So and then also like flours and sugars, salt, and all the basic stuff that you need for cooking eggs, butter, all of that stuff. I swear to God, you can make a million different things. Some people, it's so sad because I see people go, young kids, well, like 19, they're in college, and they're away from mom and dad, and they go right straight for the ramen noodles. By the way, that are getting expensive. They're like $4 and up now for like, they used to be, but $4, I want to say $4. If I gave you $10, I can teach you how to shop, and you can get like amazing things that dinner. You can make breakfast, lunch, and dinner on $10 for 3 days. Guarantee. That's what I do. But it's all because you're taking that time to cook from scratch, you guys. Cook from scratch, and you can have pancakes in the morning, waffles. You can have anything that you have. Hot cross buns. the list goes on what you can do. Okay, so yeah, it's, as you can see, it's like, it looked like it was like a big deal, but it really isn't. How many ingredients did I use? You probably have that stuff right in your kitchen already, and you're thinking, oh, I don't have any desserts in the house, I don't have this, I don't have that. Like, no, you do. You just don't know how to like put all the recipe, like all the ingredients that you have in your house, and put them together in a special kind of way, and to make something amazing. Okay, so I'm gonna wrap this up for you guys. Oh, and I'm gonna get back to you later. To sum it up about the Kanye West, really, really quick, what he did on that concert night, oh my God, you guys, like, I can't even believe it. And then for him to have a meltdown like that. So basically his concert, his year-long concert, that was canceled. And also he lost about $10 million from all of this. And the people who attended that concert, they're demanding a refund. And it's just crazy. And yeah, so he's still forced into a mental health facility, and it's just so sad, right? I don't know, we'll see. But that's the 411 on that. So I'm gonna wrap this this up, and I hope that you guys liked it. Please leave your comments below. Oh, mwah, mwah. Love everybody.
Okay, so really, really quick, the pies are out of the oven. This is what they look like. Yummy. And I'm going to show you what it looks like when I cut it open, okay? So, it's really crunchy. You hear that? Yeah. I can't wait. So, that's the top of the crust. That's the crumbly part. And just quickly. Okay. Let's put that over here. Okay, here's the plate. So I'm going to reach over here. Ugh. Come out, darling. Come out. I'm not going to hurt you. I just want to eat you. My goodness. All right, yes. Look at it, you guys. Ah, it's so yummy looking. All right, I want you to see up close. See, this is what it looks like. Do you see it? Oh my goodness. There you go. That's what it looks like. Oh my gosh. And look at the side of it. Yum. I cannot wait to have this. Yes. Okay, and then I'm also going to have like a glass of milk. And that's it. Okay, so now I'm going to taste it. I know it's like a little dark in here now because it's dark out now. It took me all day to make this video. Excuse me. So here we go. Can't wait. Mm. 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 Mm.
Oh my god, it tastes so good, you guys. Alright, so I'm gonna go finish eating this. This is totally worth it. I'm gonna go finish eating this, and I hope that you guys enjoyed this video.
Okay.